For the latest on the COVID-19 situation in Pasig, we have Mayor Vico Sotto. Good morning to you, Mayor Vico.
Hi, Ms. Karen. Good morning po.
All right. It's been a while since I last had you on Headstart. So I want to thank you, Mayor, for coming back to the show.
Thank you for having me.
All right. Let's start first with what is the latest. Can you give me the numbers on Pasig today?
Right. Well, right now we're preparing against a possible surge. Hopefully it doesn't happen, but we have to be prepared for the worst. Ika nga. So we're focusing on the vaccination as everyone else is. So far, we have had 322,000 plus jabs. This is as of yesterday. So second dose, more than 100,000 na po. So of course, we're limited by the number of supplies that we have. But whatever we receive, we use as fast as possible.
Oo. And what is the strategy of passing? For example, do they have to pre-register or do you already allow walk-ins like other cities?
We really avoid having walk-ins, Ms. Karen, because we tried it actually. And more often than not, it becomes a little bit chaotic. Not to say that it's perfect the way it is now. It's definitely not. And we're always trying to improve. But opening it up to everyone, when actually we haven't experienced the problem of vaccine hesitancy in terms of the vaccination rollout. We understand that there are still people who are hesitant about receiving vaccines. And every day, confidence increases, hopefully. But insofar as confidence as compared to the supply available is concerned, we haven't had this problem yet. In fact, there are much more people who want to be vaccinated than there are supplies. So if we just open it up to walk-in, baka magkagulo, and that's what happened the time we tried it.
Oh, and I wanted to say that you in your social media account even defended and said, because there were comments that vaccination in Pasig was slow. So you put it into context that it wasn't about it being slow. It's a fact that you lack supply.
Yeah, it's not really fair. And that's not, I don't think that's the sentiment of the majority. No? Pero minsan may magsasabi ko, bakit sa gantong LGU mas mabilis? Sometimes they say, buti pa sa Pasig, mas mabilis. Minsan may ganun din. Ano? But I think that's unfair, not only to us, but to the other LGUs. Kasi yung supply po na hawak namin ngayon, ay kung ano lang po yung nakalaan para sa amin mula sa national. And it's not the national's fault as well, because they're having difficulties with supply and they have to manage all these different LGUs nationwide. Kung ilan yung i-allocate, kung sino dapat ang priority. It's a very difficult situation. But with that said, the speed that we go about our vaccination program, it really depends on how many vaccines we have. We can't go faster than the number of vaccines we have. So if we only have, for instance, 10,000 vaccines, in 2 days, ubus na yun for first dose namin. So ganun lang yun. So I hope that the people will understand and will also be patient with us because we can't go too fast because we don't have available supplies.
Yeah.
Ngayon, halos wala kami pang first dose.
Oo. Ngayon, may inventory ka ba, Mayor? May stock ka ngayon?
We have enough for the second doses. So yung mga nagjujue for second dose, nagagawa naman namin. Pero yung para sa first dose, we have a very, very limited number. In fact, in ilan days, sa ilan araw lang, wala na kami ulit na first dose.
Okay. So I'll ask about that later on. I know that you can actually do 8,000 inoculations a day. You've done that already or ito ang capability ng Pasig?
Naabot na po namin yung 8,000 per day. Sa totoo, kung assuming, let's say, kunyari may unlimited supply of vaccine tayo, hanggang 10,000 kaya po namin eh. But you know, right now, we can do maybe 5,000, 6,000, depending on the supplies.
Oo. You did say also that you will be closing down some vaccination hubs because of the lack of supply of vaccine. Can you tell us ilan bang hubs ang isasara sa Pasig?
Last week, we closed some of the schools, you know, and we closed our private partnership with Arcovia temporarily because we didn't have enough anymore for first dose.
Oo. So two?
No. I can't remember the exact numbers, ano, pero nagsara kami ng ilan. Pero nagbukas din for second dose.
So
okay naman ngayon, binuksan na rin for second dose. Pero yun nga, kung may first dose kami na available, kahit siguro lima within the week, kaya namin magbukas pa.
I'm curious, itong 322,000 plus vaccine used already, is this already half of the population in Pasig? How many would you need technically? How many vaccines does Pasig need?
Lumalabas po dun sa latest census data. The PSA has given us their latest census. Nasa mga 800 to 900,000 ang official population namin. So you can compute from there. But we want to estimate it at 1 million para sigurado. So that means we should vaccinate 700,000 people. So understand, if we overestimate, bababa yung numbers namin, we might look bad, but that's okay. Importante, mas pessimistic yung view natin para mas mataas din yung targets natin. So with that numbers, medyo, ano pa, wala pa tayong halfway. Ano? Yung fully inoculated natin, somewhere between 10 and 13%.
Now, a congresswoman a few weeks ago complained na may palakasan system daw in the distribution of vaccines. Do you agree with that?
I haven't seen or felt any palakasan system sa kung paano nilalaan yung bakuna sa iba't ibang LGU. No? I think Secretary Galvez, Secretary Dison, the whole IATF, they've been fair. Siguro ito yung isa sa mga example na you can't please everyone because you know there are so many cities and municipalities in the Philippines talagang hindi and provinces mahirap talaga considering na limited ang supply but you know we've seen that they've been very objective siguro kung ano yung strategy o ano kung saan dapat yung inuna that's for them to explain to the public but kami, alam lang namin kung ilan yung naka-allocate para sa amin.
Actually, Pasig City has been praised in terms of vaccine rollout. You were the first LGU that was praised for excellent vaccine rollout. I wanted to ask you, what do you think made your strategy different for Pasig to be noticed?
I'm not really sure what we've done different. We've tried to do things as fast as we can. There are hitches along the way. May isang araw, that was a Tuesday, na text para pumunta, nagka-human error dun sa system. For Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, pumunta sa isang araw, nagkagulo kami. So that you know, those kinds of things really happen. But what's important is that we try to act as fast as we can. You know, from the creation of the micro plan, even before vaccines arrived, engaging our private partners, you can say you can say a lot of things, but definitely we have tried and done our best from the start.
Did Pasig order its own supply?
Opo, meron po kaming order ng 400,000 doses from AstraZeneca. We've received a very very small percentage of that, and hopefully by August we'll receive a little bit more. It's not that much, but. Yeah. Hopefully it will help. We ordered 400,000 but you know hopefully by the year we receive a substantial amount. Ngayon wala pa.
Yeah, pero it's still amazing that kahit papaano yung personal order ng LGU may nakuha ka na. Maraming LGU wala pang personal deliveries.
Maliit na percentage lang, Ms. Karen, wala pang ano. So ilan ba yon? 11,000 11,000 yung dumating na. We ordered 400,000, so it's really not that much.
You're right. Okay, I wanted to ask you about the A4 vaccination. Now, I know you're limited with a COVAX facility. You cannot use vaccines coming from COVAX.
Correct.
Let's talk about the A4. All right. Where are you now in terms of A4 vaccinations?
As of yesterday, if I'm not mistaken, we've vaccinated around 44,000, maybe 45,000 under A4. So the real number of workers that we've vaccinated should be a little bit higher kasi meron sa kanilang ibang A3, meron din sa kanilang ibang A2. So mas mataas yung number of vaccine na-vaccinate na natin na A4. As you mentioned, we're limited by the fact that those coming from the COVAX facility are not allowed to be used on A4. Minsan tinatanong ako, ba't ganun? Well, yun yung condition ng donation sa atin. It's as simple as that. So we use that for A5. So for A5, we've actually vaccinated around 15,000 already. Kung sino yung identified natin indigents and so on. But you know, we're limited by, again, to sound like a broken record already, but we're limited by the number of vaccines that we have and that are allowed to be used for A4.
Okay, and how do you vaccinate A4? I know in A4 kasi may pila pa yun under, eto muna under A4. Or do you already open it to everyone under A4?
Ang instruction sa amin ay basta A4, wag na natin gawin komplikado. Kasi diba initially may 0.1, 0.2, 0.3. Medyo magulo, hindi ko nga matanda na kung 17 subcategories ba yun or padagdag ng padagdag. But we're thankful to the national because they simplified it a little bit. So yung A4 is A4. Basta economic frontliner ka na nagtatrabaho sa labas ng bahay, okay na, pwede ka nang mabakunahan. So we have a two-pronged approach here. The first one is through Pasig Pass. Everyone in Pasig basically virtually uses Pasig Pass. Ito yung contact tracing digital solution namin. So if you've been outside your house in the last several months, you've used Pasig Pass. So everyone has this. There's a registration button on Pasig Pass, the website. It's very accessible. If you don't have access to the internet, you can go to your health center. You can ask assistance from the barangay. You can even go to City Hall. They'll help you register. And then we go there, first come, first serve. But the second part is through the companies. Some companies will approach us. Again, first come, first serve. They submit to us their master list. And then isasama na namin yun sa vaccination. There's some special considerations. Yung iba magdo-donate ng bakuna sa amin. Hindi pa namin natanggap, ano, pero there's an agreement like that. So, ayun po. But overall,
But that's quite innovative. That's quite innovative. It's first come, first serve, but it's quite innovative in the sense that you use other tools other than your basic registration for the A4. Kasi meron kang passing pass at may company list.
Master list, yes.
And that's a big innovation in terms of yung A4 mas madali.
Tama po. And this is especially helpful kasi yung instructions sa atin, that the guidelines nationally are, kung A4 ka, pwede ka mabakunahan sa place of residence or place of work. Kasi maaaring sa probinsya talaga ang place of residence mo, pero dito ka nagtatrabaho, hindi naman pwede uuwi ka pa sa probinsya para mabakunahan. So this especially helps us with those who are not actually Pasig residents, but work here in Pasig and will affect the numbers of Pasig. So through the company, nakukuha namin yung details nila.
I'm curious, the DepEd recently announced that they partnered with the Pasig LGU to start inoculating teachers. I want to understand this more. Itong teachers na ito, is it only public school teachers based in Pasig? What's the system?
Sa ngayon, ang public school teachers namin ay halos lahat na bakunahan na.
Okay.
90%+++%. Siyempre may mga iba medyo ayaw pa. Pero lahat ng gusto na bakunahan na namin. The central office of DepEd is actually in Pasig. So may ultra. So we've also helped to vaccinate their staff and some of the other teachers as well. So sa Pasig teachers, that's around 5,000. Yung sa staff nila, nasa 1,000 din po yun. And we're very glad to help with this.
Oo. And itong partnership na to is only for teachers who are teaching in Pasig. I'm curious kasi what if may public school teacher within nearby cities that want to be inoculated in Pasig?
Right now, we have not accommodated them yet. But yung staff ng central, and that includes some teachers as well, I suppose, not necessarily Pasig residents.
Pasig.
Pero basta yung nag-report sa central office, which is in Pasig, we've also inoculated as well. So that's ongoing. Pero yung teachers namin, mga 5,000, tapos na. And then we're also reaching out to the private school teachers. This is a first step in preparation for face-to-face, whenever that may be. Hindi naman natin alam kung kailan talaga yun. Pero nakita natin, hirap na hirap, I might be jumping to another topic, ano, pero kita natin, hirap na hirap na talaga yung mga students and parents and teachers dun sa virtual classes eh.
Yeah. Okay. No, we'll talk about that later on. And I want to ask you just very quickly. Vaccine education is the challenge. Just quickly, how are you doing it in Pasig? For example, mababa ang bilang ng elderly na gustong magpabakuna. Secretary Galvez said that.
Well, this is true, and we're doing our best information campaign both on social media and on the ground, pati yung pagpapaskil ng TARP. Pero nakita kasi namin na ang pinaka-epektibong paraan para makumbinsi ang isang tao na mabakunahan ay word of mouth. Kahit anong commercial sa TV, kahit anong Facebook post, kahit anong sabihin ko, ang pinaka-nakapagtataas ng kumpiyansa ng tao sa bakuna ay pag nakita na, ay yung pinsan ko na bakunahan na, okay naman siya.
Tama.
Ay yung anak ko na bakunahan, senior na, ayun, anak ko na bakunahan na. Nahawaan siya ng COVID, halos wala siyang symptoms. Yun yung talagang, that's what really increases the vaccine confidence. Mm-hmm. Kaya kami po, actually sa senior citizens natin, let me take a quick look at the numbers.
Sure.
Mataas-taas yung confidence. In fact, we've vaccinated.
In Pasig, that's a good one.
Our number of seniors in Pasig may be around 60,000. Could be a little more, a little less. Probably a little more, may iba di naman naka-register. Pero ang nabakunahan na ay first dose ay almost 50,000.
Wow.
So, halos lahat ng senior citizens na Pasigueño ay nabakunahan na. Ibig sabihin, halos lahat ay confident sa vaccine. Marami pa kaming nasa list na hindi pa nababakunahan. Well, hindi marami, pero may ilan pa sa list na hindi pa nababakunahan. So the confidence of senior citizens in Pasig would be somewhere around 90%. So we don't have the problem of vaccine hesitancy here for senior citizens especially.
I'm curious, are you doing another strategy for seniors? There were several discussions on dapat pag senior dalit sa barangay ang bakuna, dapat puntahan sa bahay, marunong mag-online.
Yes, the problem for us here is actually minimal. Hindi ko naman alam paano nakapag-rehistro ang bawat senior, ano, pero meron iba tinutulungan ng anak, tinutulungan ng apo, at marami kasi yun nga yung Pasig Pass, sa tingin ko dahil yung Pasig Pass yung naging base namin, naging ano na, mabilis na yung pag-register sa vaccine kasi everyone had months to create their Pasig Pass account, so familiar sila dun sa ano, familiar na sila sa sistema. But number two, there are those who are bedridden, who cannot leave their homes. Under the care of our hospice program, ito po ay hin-house to house namin.
Nag-house to house ka pala.
Yes.
Okay.
Limited number yung kaya po namin dito kasi it requires a pull out of staff from the vaccination site. Ibig sabihin, kung nasa house to house sila, wala sila sa site. So limited number lang po, nasa 20 per day. Pero inuubos namin yun. So initially, we had around 400 plus in that list. We're finished with that 400 plus. Now we're taking requests in case that, you know, there are bedridden seniors or even not seniors who are not on, in our master list. Yan, ina-accommodate na po namin ngayon.
Pero that's a more, I have to say, proactive strategy in getting seniors vaccinated. Na yung iba talagang hin-house to house nyo. That was a discussion before eh. Kung dapat i-include ang house to house. So it's effective, Mayor.
For the bedridden, yes. Hindi natin siya kaya gawin sa malakihang scale.
Okay.
We cannot do this on a mass scale. It will take too much of our resources and manpower. Pero kung ilang daan lang yan, kaya natin.
Okay. Let's talk about the vaccination cards. Would you consider the Pasig Pass, can that be a vaccination card? Or it cannot? It is already?
Well, not a card, but it... ganito po ginawa namin sa Pasig Pass. We've tried to integrate it with all the different systems. So, for example, the CDRS system of DOH, which contains PCR test results. It's integrated to our Pasig Pass. Next step, we integrated it. Obviously, it's integrated for our contact tracing kasi that's what it was designed for. We've integrated to four other LGUs as well, or five other LGUs, including Valenzuela and Mandaluyong. And then now for vaccination, it's also integrated with our vaccination records. So lahat nandito na sa Pasig Pass. So hindi mo kailangan mag-download ng isa pang app, hindi mo kailangan ng dalawang QR code. And when you go to the vaccination center, again, you need Pasig Pass to register for vaccination, first and foremost. Second, when you go to the vaccination site, at every step of the way, gagamitin yung QR code mo. It can be through the phone or printed QR code. And then once you're actually done vaccinated, they will print you a vaccination card. And in that vaccination card is the QR code of your Pasig Pass. So it's the same QR code. And this helps actually prevent counterfeits as well. So una, it's just more convenient. Mas madali lang po talaga. Kasi isa lang yung QR code mo. Wala kang bagong QR code for vaccination. It's the same. Pangalawa, it helps us prevent counterfeits. Kasi titingnan mo lang using a Pasig Pass scanner yung vaccination card, may kita mo kung totoo yan. May picture niya dun. Alam mo kung totoo or hindi yung card.
I'm curious, do you require in Pasig, let's say we eat in restaurants or enter offices in Pasig, that everyone has a Pasig Pass kahit hindi taga-Pasig?
Opo, there is a threshold, a certain size of establishments. Pero halimbawa, mall. Papasok ka ng mall, papasok ka ng restaurant, yun, kailangan ng Pasig Pass. At kung wala silang Pasig Pass, i-report nyo sa akin, isusususpend ko yung business permit nila.
So, but even, no, that's interesting. So, this is for this is for information for all of us. Ang EDSA Shangri-La is in Pasig.
No, that's Mandaluyong.
Ang
sa amin Ayala, the 30th.
Ayun. Okay.
Capital Commons.
Okay, so yun, Capital Commons, Ayala 30th. Like ako, taga Makati ako. So if I enter a restaurant in Ayala 30th, for example, right, I need a Pasig Pass.
Tama po. Hindi kayo papapasukin ng mall pa lang kung wala kayong Pasig Pass. But the good news is also we've integrated with other LGUs contact tracing apps. So if you have a QR code from Pasig, Mandaluyong, Valenzuela. Valenzuela was the first, by the way. Valenzuela, Antipolo, Taytay. Yun, lima po kami. You just need one QR code for those five LGUs.
Paano mo nagawa to, Mayor Vico? Why did you choose the five and you didn't include the other LGUs? I'm just curious.
Well, first of all, we have to give credit where credit is due. I got this idea from Mayor Rex of Valenzuela, and we basically just copied them. Okay. We've made enhancements to Pasig Pass, but the system, the main system for contact tracing came from Valenzuela.
Okay.
And then these five LGUs happen to be under the same developer as we are.
Of the digital platform.
Same developer po kami. So yeah, interoperable po sila. And our data, our contact tracing data is actually integrated. So kung may nakita kami na pumunta ng Valenzuela, ino-notify din namin, pwede namin i-notify din yung SESU nila. Now, if you're asking bakit, bakit lima lang? Bakit kami? Well, kami pa lang yung gumagamit ng app this specific under this specific developer. But actually, if you look at the back end, kaya po namin mag-integrate even with Stay Safe, the national app. The two developers have already worked together and it's already okay, good na po siya. Inaantay na lang namin na bigyan kami ng go signal ng DILG, but the system is already ready. And it can be, kahit bukas, kaya po namin i-on yung feature.
No, this is what's surprising about you sharing this is why are we still waiting for the DICT? Until now, there is no unified pass, so to speak, for vaccination, information of vaccination. And yet you've done it na lima kayo.
Well, to be fair to them, they do have the Stay Safe app. And we've seen the potential. Kasi hindi pa talaga siya, aminin natin, hindi pa naman talaga siya widely used. Sana it works out. Kasi kung integration lang ang pag-uusapan, and we're thankful to the DLG because they've recognized Pasig Pass and the other apps of these LGUs. There are other LGUs elsewhere in the province that also have their own their own local contact tracing apps. Pero sa totoo, kaya naman natin i-integrate. We just have to wait for the go signal.